This is Theodorus Rex, and welcome back for another Track by Track. And today's special occasion for these two bands, I'm breaking out some whiskey, if you don't mind. These two albums came out in 1992, and they both had a profound impact on my psyche. Straight up. We have Core from Stone Temple Pilots versus Dirk from Alice in Chains, both monumental recordings and huge influence on my playing and my style. What I listen to, I think, you've got Dean DeLeo, Scott Weiland, Lane Staley, Jerry Cantrell. I mean, what is not to like? And a battle mano a mano against these amazing songs on each album. Anyway, Core, was recorded over a period of 5 weeks. When that first came out, they've got the Pearl Jam, comparisons, and then the video from Plush and the Rolling Stones. They were voted both at the simultaneously the best and worst band to come out that year. Dirt was the second full-length album from Alice in Chains, spawned 5 singles, and was on the Billboard charts for nearly a year. I happened to see Alice in Chains during this time open for Van Halen on the For and Lawful Carnal Knowledge tour. Good show. Lane Staley was like a statue on stage, didn't really move. He just stood there singing his songs like this. He did throw a pizza in the audience though at one time, I remember. And I saw Stone Temple Pilots twice. Had the luxury of seeing them in New Orleans on 1995, which was a terrific show. And then again in 2010 in St. Augustine, Florida, where they were kind of mailing it in. Anyway, let's start off with the first track, which is Dead and Bloated versus Them Bones. Now, I like both these songs. I can both listen to either one of them at any point in time and really enjoy them. But really, I think Dead and Bloated goes above and beyond. And whenever you start an album off with "I am smelling like a rose that somebody gave me," yeah. Not only that, but you've got a dozen or so riffs piled on top of each other with a really interesting arrangement, and Dean DeLeo's sound here, the tone on his guitar is just fantastic. I think it's a Les Paul there. And Them Bones, you've got a couple riffs, and it's just a good rocking number. This one is going to Stone Temple Pilots without question. Track 2. Sex Type Thing versus Damn That River. Now, Sex Type Thing, very masculine song. We've got you shouldn't have worn that dress lyrics, versus Damn That River, which is it's a good song, but as far as Dirt goes, it's not one of the better songs on Dirt, I don't think. But Sex Type Thing is one of the better songs on Core, so we're going 2 for Stone Temple Pilots here. Track 3, Wicked Garden, a single, versus It's Gonna Rain When I Die by Alice in Chains. Now, I really like Rain When I Die. I think even when I listen to it, I almost feel the rain. I hear the rain. It's one of those songs you want to play when it's raining. And Wicked Garden, it is a good number. It's rocking. It's kind of I really don't know what to say. It was a good choice for a single. I think it's got an interesting arrangement and it's got clever hooks. But for my money, I'm going with Alice in Chains on this one. Score 1 for them. Track 4. No Memory versus Down in a Hole. Now this, I love Down in a Hole. There is no competition here. I think No Memory doesn't even really stick in my memory, okay? Forget about that song. Dust it off the album. And Down in a Hole. I mean, it's a powerful, lyrically very powerful song. And also is very dramatic, dramatically performed. Track 5, Sin versus Sick Man. Sick Man is a very original tune, and I really like Sin. And this one is kind of hard to pick, which one is really the better tune here. But for my money, I think Sick Man is just interesting, a little more interesting. I think the guitar riffs are driving. It's got a lot of energy, and when Lane Staley's singing he's physically hitting his Adam's apple as he sings there, that's a winner. That's a winner in my book, so that one goes to Alice in Chains. Track 6, Naked Sunday versus Rooster. Once again, I think you've got a tough mountain to climb if you think you're going to top Rooster. I mean, this is a song that Jerry Cantrell wrote about his father going to Vietnam, and the lyrics are very poignant, and they kind of paint a picture in your mind. And not only that, but the music is also dramatic, and just a well done effort on that part. Without question, this one easily goes to Rooster. Track 7, Creep single versus Junkhead. Now, Creep, you know, is an acoustic number, and you know, it's got some clever lines, you know, like I'm half the man I used to be. But for my money, Junkhead is just such a powerful song, and it's so heavy. The drums in this song just driving and driving, and it's my favorite song on the album. So clearly, it's going in the Alice in Chains column. Track 8, Piece of Pie versus Dirt, the title track. And Piece of Pie is another favorite of mine from Core. You know, it's got, you don't know my name, you know what about me. Yeah. So it's Whelan really shines on this song, and the whole band comes together collectively in a really great way. Dirt is, you know, is also got some interesting lyrics about being dug under by your talent and just feeling like shit and just being almost like humiliated, you know. And kind of a downer song, really, but in any event, I'm going with Stone Temple Pilots on this one. Track 9. Plush, the single, which was huge, huge, huge. I still play this song in some of my gigs, versus Godsmack. And I think, you know, Godsmack does have something to offer, but Plush clearly is the winner here. I mean, do I need to even talk about it? I mean, we've all heard it a million times, and it's just a staple of that era. The 1992 era, I think. So let's move on. Track 10, Wet My Bed, which was kind of an improvisational tune when they first came into the studio. I think it was the first track that they even recorded for the album, but it's only a minute long or so, and it's just kind of some silliness. Versus Iron Gland, which actually has Tom Araya from Slayer on vocals, which is also, sounds like it's somewhat improvised and is only about a minute long. So, you know, what have you, whatever. I'm going with Stone Temple Pilots on this one, so there you have it. Carry on. Track 11, Cracker Man versus Hate to Feel. Hate to Feel is kind of a forgettable number, and there's not many on Dirt. In fact, they could have just left this completely off the album, and I would have been fine with it, you know. But Cracker Man, on the other hand, has a lot of energy. And I've even seen, you know, Stone Temple Pilots open some shows with it, you know, and he pulls out the bullhorn and sings through the bullhorn. Easily going to Stone Temple Pilots on that one. So, we're getting up on track 12 here, Where the River Goes versus Angry Chair. Man, we're very close here. I think I'm giving this one to Angry Chair because I love the video, and I also think the riff is very unique. It's not often you hear a riff quite like the one Jerry Cantrell's throwing on us here. And in the video, he's playing the Ernie Ball, you know, Eddie Van Halen guitar. And I'm wondering if he got one of those guitars on tour. I think he did. I think Eddie Van Halen gave him one of the Ernie Balls while they were touring together, and it made its way into that video. And it's a terrific song, without question, and very original. So what are we at, 6-6, right? 4-5, yeah, 6-6, a complete tie. Tie game. Sadly, that's all Stone Temple Pilots left us with, whereas Alice in Chains went that extra mile and delivered a song called Wood at the very end. I think you're all familiar with that song. Terrific song. Again, lyrically, Lane really shows up, and I think Cantrell's writing a lot of lyrics as well, so let's give credit where credit is due. But Wood is a song that would last decades, you know. So there you have it. I'm going to give the winner is Alice in Chains by 1 point here. Not really a knockout, but 6-7. Congratulations, Jerry Cantrell and Lane Staley. Rest in peace. And actually, what are the odds there? Scott Whelan, rest in peace. Anyway, thanks for watching. Let me know what you think about the songs. If you got some different ideas, put your ideas in the comments. I would love to hear from you. Take care and have a good night.